We've made up our minds. We're going to do new. Do something else. Do more. Do the impossible. Do better. Do good. Do big. Do small. Do it wrong. Do it again. Do it ourselves. Do it together. Do what no one else has done. Do what will become big. Do the same. Do different. Do everything. Do something. Do new.
Hello, and welcome to a webinar from Linköping University. Today, we are going to talk about our new master program in cybersecurity. I'm Karina Sjöberg, working at International Student Recruitment at Linköping University, and I'm here with my colleague, and we will guide you today. First of all, some practicalities. There are two parts in this webinar. The first one will be recorded, and you will find it on YouTube and on our own website as well. The second one is a Q&A section, and it will only be available live. So, once again, very welcome. Today, I have the program coordinator for cybersecurity with me. So maybe you would like to introduce yourself.
Thank you. My name is Mikael Asplund, and I'm a coordinator for this master program. I'm also an associate professor in computer science, where I do at Linköping University, where I do research and teaching in these courses.
Lovely. So what is the background to the program? Why cybersecurity?
So we see an enormous need in society now with companies and organizations struggling with this huge challenge across whole of Europe, where you need to increase the level of cybersecurity to keep society safe and secure. And that's why we as a university need to do our role in educating people to fill these demand from industry and government organizations.
And how is it relevant? Could you exemplify?
Well, I mean, it's relevant because we see a lot of, you know, we see an increase in threats from cyber criminals and other, you know, places in the world where they try to threaten core values and core infrastructure in society. So, for example, our electrical grid or water supply or financial systems and all these things. Or just things like the municipality and the local healthcare center and all these services that we expect from society, we need to protect them. And there is a need for competence both at the technical level, but also at the organizational and human level to counteract these threats.
What I guess you have quite a good overview of the different universities offering courses in cybersecurity. What is it that sets us apart from the other ones?
Well, I mean, there are many good programs, of course, but I think we are doing very well in terms of both looking at the whole stack in terms of from the low level detailed technical courses like software security and cryptography up to organizational level and how to implement cybersecurity in an organization. So that's a key strength for our program. And also the region that we are situated in has a lot of companies and organizations working in this area, so the whole region is very strong in this way. And I also would like to lift up the fact that we are doing, of course, we do the theory, but we also do the hands-on part. So we're very good at laboratory work, project work, where you actually get to get hands-on experience and really learn how to do it, not just the theory about it.
Now, I know we use cross the disciplinarity and multiple fields. So you would say that is something that comes back in this program as well?
Absolutely, yes. And that's what I was hinting at as well, in this high level organization theory and also humans in cybersecurity. How do we react as humans to different protections and weaknesses in systems, and it's a really, really important factor. So it's a cross-cutting concern, and that is also reflected in the program.
Yeah, I would like to have an overview of the program, if possible. So there you can see the first semester is set. The other ones is they are preliminary, as you can see. As often in an engineering program, you will study several subjects parallelly. Each semester is divided into two sets, each of 10 weeks. The first one in professionalism in cybersecurity. Could you say a few words about that?
Well, yeah, so that's a sort of introductory course where you both get to learn how to study at master level, which is, of course, for many a new experience. It's a different way of learning, perhaps, compared to bachelor level courses, and you need to learn about that. But we also have elements of ethics and elements of sustainability, which are really important for your future professional career as a cybersecurity expert.
Yeah. So, and the fourth semester is devoted entirely to a thesis work. Do the students have to start looking for a thesis very early?
Well, we do recommend that you start around September in the semester before. So that's the spring semester, and you start around September, October, looking for a master thesis. Also because we have a preparatory course, the course in scientific method, which starts at the second period of the third semester that prepares for the master thesis work.
With your experience, what is the master student struggles with most, having the bachelor's with them and the change in being on master level?
Well, of course, the challenges are often more open-ended, and you need to be able to perhaps be more self-guided and able to identify the kind of material that you need to learn in order to solve the problems. It's maybe not so clear-cut and directed as you have to do in the undergraduate, the first bachelor level courses. So it's more open-ended, especially the project work. But of course, I would say that for some, it's a new challenge also to have a lot of practical hands-on parts of the courses. It's not just about studying the book and doing that in an exam. So that's also something that you really need. You need to put a lot of effort into the studies. Yes.
Yeah. So it is an analytical step up, and it's also a thing that if you haven't done things practically before, that is also another dimension which is entered into the set.
Yeah.
What about links to industry? You said we had a strong region. Could you indicate some names, maybe?
Yeah, sure. I mean, we have Ericsson is a big company worldwide, which has a big office in Linköping. We have companies like Sectra, Combitech. We have Saab. We have many, many different companies specializing in cybersecurity as well. Those are some of the maybe bigger ones, but also a lot of small and medium-sized companies around. There is a lot, and there is a lot of activity around the subject at the moment. So also around companies that were not before perhaps specializing in cybersecurity, they now see the need to increase their competence level, and they're doing projects and investments in this area. So there is a lot of opportunity for interacting with regional companies and national, of course, as well. Yes.
How interesting. What would a typical week look like?
So typical, you would have a number of lectures. Depends on the courses, of course, the amount, but not the full week of schedules, but you would have a number of schedules every week, and you would have quite a lot of exercise sessions where you get help from tutors to solve problems. It's a lot of problem solving activities, and of course also lab times where you actually sit down in computer labs typically solve problems or actually work together. It could also, we have many different sort of project courses where you work together with other students, and those are not scheduled per se, but you organize your own time and you work with this kind of project work.
So you should expect to be putting in a lot of time, at
least
40 hours
per
week.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah.
I've also heard that you have labs during evening time. Is that correct?
Yeah, it happens. Yes, yes, that there are labs during evening time. Depends on the courses, but of course there is also a lot of a lot of the time, I would say most of the time during the week, you have to study in your own under your own guidance or together with others, so to speak. So it's not scheduled hours, but time that you're expected to put into your studies.
So I mean, security, cybersecurity, it is kind of a sensitive area. If I'm a non-EU citizen, will this affect me in any way during classes or?
No, work? So you're free to apply and you can take all the classes and all the courses in the program. Of course, some of these organizations that are in the region might be having sensitive information and working in sensitive areas, and they might not be able to take in as interns or during the master's thesis project or later as a full-time employee if you come from sort of outside Sweden or from outside Europe. So that depends, but there is the sector, the demand for the competence is very big also across the whole society. So it's not necessarily that you won't be able to get a job or anything if you come from outside EU. But of course, it helps, being a European citizen.
So when we talk about challenges, as a teacher, could you say something about the support we are able to offer for international students?
In terms of the course contents, I would say we do provide a lot of support. So we are we have a strong pedagogical tradition at the university. So I would say that we give a lot of opportunities for the students to get support from the teachers in the tasks they have to do. So we don't always give them easy tasks, but we help them along the way. We'd like to think that if you put the effort in, you will manage. That's clear. And you have the background, of course.
And there's also, I know, some academic English support, but of course, English is important.
Sure, yeah.
Yeah, you have to fulfill the entry requirements in English, and if you're thinking IELTS, then it is 6.5 on average. As TOEFL, you have to have 90. And even if you have 89, I'm sorry, then you're not admitted. So you have to fulfill the entry requirements, which are the formal ones. But then, of course, you have to be able to read and understand and also write and present the classes, understand.
Yeah, absolutely. You have to be able to communicate without any effort in English, and also to write. We have technical report writing, and in the end you have to write a master's thesis, which is a scientific report, and that has to be of a very good quality in the end. Yeah.
And then if you have if you are cooperating with a company during your thesis, you also have a supervisor at the company and at the university.
And at the university, that's correct, yes.
And both of those two parties have to be okay with the final result.
Yes, of course, yes.
So what would you say when it comes to the background of a student? Can you say something?
Yeah, so it's a master program, so you have to have a bachelor in computer science or related area and sufficient amount of math courses, because we have some technically challenging courses in the program, so we require that kind of sufficiently deep technical background. But of course, you also need to be very interested in the subject and motivated and willing to learn more and not shy away from a challenge. That's clear.
What I've heard from other students is that those 10 weeks, they tend to go very fast, very quickly. So don't be a slow starter. Get started from the beginning. And also now when you're thinking about applying, there are some courses in mathematics which are specific entry requirements, so be sure to check those out. Verify that you have those names on your transcript of records. And if you do not, then you should upload the syllabus for the course where you study this. This is, for example, discrete mathematics and calculus, but check them out on the program homepage to be sure not to miss anything. So, as we don't have our student with us here today, when it comes to our student life and living in Sweden and Linköping, I today have to refer you to our international student bloggers. You're more than welcome to ask them any questions linked to student life, how to be a student here, student associations. There are plenty, I assure you. Usually when I talk to a prospective student, I tell them to, if you have an interest, a sport, a theatre, journalism, or a photo, whatever, right now, bring that interest with you and try to find that sports association or continue with the interest, because that is an excellent way to meet Swedish students and also have something else on your mind. Sometimes you just need to relax to have a good work-life balance. Being a master's student here is very demanding, especially at the engineering faculty. And thus, it is important to handle time management, both being active as a student, but also have the time to relax. So, is there anything else on from your side that you would like to enter when it comes to the program or the students that we'd like to see here?
Well, not really, but I think that it's a great opportunity to go into this area now. I think that the demand from, as I was saying in the beginning, the demand from society is so high. I was just at a conference on SCADA security, which is security of industrial control systems, grids, and these kind of services, and you see there's such a need and there's such a demand from companies and from society. So I would say that it's a really great opportunity to get into a career where you can make a difference and actually make a positive contribution to society. So yeah, I think it's the right time to go to this area. Yeah.
Okay, lovely to hear. You have a great future in front of you. So I think it's time for us to end this part where we have been recording. And in a few seconds, we will continue with the Q&A section. For those who are here with us live, others, you are welcome to send us any question or go on Instagram and chat with us there. But for that part, we say thank you and goodbye.